Hey everyone, welcome back to another Figma animation tutorial. I keep on exploring cool new designs on Dribbble, and I recently came across this parallax text animation. I instantly loved it and decided to recreate that effect in Figma. This is the final output that I created. It may not be as cool as TM website, but it still looks really good. So without further delay, let's get started. Creating any animation requires planning ahead of time. First, break down interaction in logical steps. So in this case, we have three steps. First, initial state where active section has black filled number and other sections have dotted numbers. Second state where the next section pushes the active section. Notice how the content scrolls and not the active section number until they are super close. And lastly, the third state, where the dotted number is converted to filled number and active section changes. Replay this animation until you fully understand these three states. Now once you understand, recreating this is very easy. So here's our practice design. You can download this file from the link in the description and the comment section. It has all the layers properly named and grouped. Dotted numbers are just text with stroke applied. You can modify these values from here. I duplicated this entire frame and changed it from stroke to fill effect. We only want some part of it visible. Hence, I'm reducing its height by holding Command key on Mac or Control key on Windows. Turn on clip content to hide numbers outside this frame. Now start by duplicating this frame. For simulating the scroll animation, we need to change viewport size or screen size. Change it the same way by holding Command key on Mac or Control key on Windows and dragging it to somewhere around 800 pixels. This is average viewport height of a browser. Now, move the content upwards carefully so that it does not go out of the frame. You can hold Shift key and use arrow keys to move it up and down. Move active section indicator line as well. Turn on clip content on the main frame to hide content outside the screen. Let's add our first interaction. Connect summary section from the header to second screen. Let's try animation as ease out and duration to 600 milliseconds. Preview animation. Looks smooth. Connect logo back to the start screen to finish this interaction. Now it's time to animate parallax text section. Duplicate the number 1 initial state. I'll remove unwanted interactions from the logo. Now we need to move all the numbers except dotted and filled number 1. You can use Command plus Shift or Control plus Shift to select all the numbers and content sections one by one. Move the section slightly below the number 1. Reduce filled numbers frame size. Now the final state. Do not select the number frame, only select the numbers inside. Select the content also and move it upwards until skill section looks active. Now only select the dotted and filled number 1 and move it outside the frame using shift and arrow keys. Change the active section indicator to skills. On the second state, extend its indicator to start of the skills. It will create nice bounce effect. Go to Prototype tab to add interactions. Connect the initial state to second state. Animation as smart animate, easing as linear, and duration to 200 milliseconds. For second state, use trigger as after delay to automatically go to the final state. With minimum delay of 1 millisecond, animation as smart animate, easing as ease out, duration as 400 milliseconds. Done. Preview the animation. Hand cursor is not appearing on the skills. Let me quickly fix the trigger. I accidentally selected the frame instead of skills from the header. Preview prototype again. Works as expected now. Now let's create reverse animation by duplicating the second frame. Connect Summary tab to reverse animation screen. In this reverse animation, number 2 is active and we want number 1 to move down. So I am copying the layers from final state to reverse state. Select filled and dotted 1 and bring it down slightly above number 2. Use time trigger of 1 millisecond to automatically move back to summary section. Preview animation. This animation looks slower. We can always fine-tune animation easing and duration. Reload prototype. Looks beautiful. Notice how indicator bounces to the new tab. I'll repeat the same steps to go to third experience section. Preview animation. This looks wonderful. We could create this animation using just smart animate and frames clip content technique. I hope you learned something new. Let me know your feedbacks in the comments below. Hit like if this was helpful and subscribe to the channel if you haven't done that already. Thanks for watching it. I'll see you in the next one.